A lot of you asked my opinion about the SuperBox S1 Pro, so here it is. Make sure to subscribe on Tech is My Passion and enable the notifications in order to get always the latest videos. Hello beautiful people and welcome to Tech is My Passion. I am Dimi and since you are on this channel, I suspect tech is your passion too. In today's video, we're gonna talk about something that I really did not like to talk about, but since a lot of you have asked my opinion, and even though I try to reply to each single one of you, as you can understand, it's really difficult for me, so I've decided to do a video instead and share my opinion, my thoughts on the SuperBox S1 Pro. First of all, let's start with the thing that I got plenty of emails, offers to review this device, but I refused each one of them simply because they want me to share also the link of their website down below in the video description of the reviewed device. One thing I don't want to do is to affiliate my name with such a device, and I'm gonna explain why. One of the motives that they wanted me to sell, to review this device, is the fact that when you review the device that costs $300, at $150 or $120 of each sale will come to me. So, as you can imagine, there is one big reason for a YouTuber, for a blogger to recommend this device. Now, I have nothing against affiliations, but on the same time, I want to be honest and always recommend products that I would really buy myself. If not, I'm just a scammer. Let's go and check out exactly the device and why I do not like it. First of all, here we are in one of the websites, because they have plenty of websites and a lot of sellers, resellers that are offering the same model. You can find them here, $299, which is in offer because the original price was $599. Okay, sure. Then we have it over here. We have it also on Amazon. So they have plenty of sellers, resellers. My suspicion is that they are Chinese, since the most people that contacted me are from China, the manufacturer, and then they have plenty of resellers all over the world, especially in the US. But in my opinion, they will be shut down. And what I mean by that is that if you are selling a device that costs $300 with the specs, where are the specs? Here they are. That are a device of 2 years ago. That's a device that I did also a review. Not exactly the same case, okay? My review was for the H6 mini device. That's exactly the same device with a different case and an external antenna. It has the same operating system, Android 7 Nougat. It has the same CPU, which isn't mentioned on the listings because the specs do not have it. But since they are talking about a quad-core ARM Cortex-A53, and it's capable of 6K, I'm sure it's the all-winner H6. And not only, there is also an Android version around, but they do not have that, of course. They have the cheaper one. That's a device that, when it was launched, and I did a review of it, I liked it, to be honest, for a budget device, but it costs $39.99 and $55.99. That's in 2018. Nowadays, if you will find it with Android 7, it will cost half at best. If it is the updated version, it may have almost the same price, but in any case, that's a very, very old device, which of course I do not recommend in 2020, and especially at that crazy price, $299. So let's go back. Why you should buy this device? Their point of selling the device is that they give you 1000 IPTV channels and more than 10,000 movies, which they say they have a license. In my opinion, and it's just my opinion to share for legal reasons, is that they have no license, and as in the past about The Dragon Box. Where is it? Here it is. I have also an article on my website. Dragon Box, they got the same thing. They had a device which was maybe even better, but that's not the point. With all the channels and stuff like that. Exactly the same methodology. And afterwards also Set TV, who also claimed to be legal. I also stayed away because I had offers from both of them in the past, but I've stayed away for the simple fact that, in my opinion, they are illegal. And I'm not here to preach you or to teach you. It's not that the issue. The issue is that I don't want my name connected, affiliated with something that is not a gray area, not something that it may be shady, that in my opinion is 100% illegal. And on the second worst, in my opinion, thing, not only I will affiliate myself with something that I do not trust, I will never buy. So if I will not never buy such a service, such a device, why should I recommend it to you? The only, of course, obvious answer is the $150-$120 on each sale. You can imagine some YouTubers or bloggers that recommend this device and have sold more than 1,000 devices. They made 6, maybe even 7 figures from affiliations. That may sound great about the money, but they will lose the trust, and that's what is all about, in my opinion. If you want to do this kind of reviews, you should be honest 100% with your people, with your subscribers, and not only your subscribers, with anyone who will watch these kind of videos. In any case, that's my take, and since they are gonna be shut down, surely you will be left with a device that costs $30 and you will have nothing to watch, because that's the issue. They will shut down this IPTV, however is it called, and you will be left with a device that it costs less than $30. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, smash the like button. Dislike if you didn't like it, especially if you are one of those YouTubers that are recommending it. Make sure to subscribe for more amazing videos. Follow me on all the social media platforms. I'm on Reddit, I'm on Instagram, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Facebook, all over the place. I'm a very social guy, at Dimitrology. Dimitrology.com for the website, and we will catch up on the upcoming video. Thank you for watching.